We visited so many amazing places. The city of Guanajuato was amazing. It really inspired the look of our land of the dead. To be honest, for me personally, my favorite time on these trips, we saw a lot of amazing things, but my favorite times were the times we spent with families. We knew that Miguel's family was going to be making shoes. We were going to have a craft, and so we would seek out families that had a family business. So we visited a family that makes papel picado, that cut paper flags. We visited a family that makes mezcal. We visited a family that makes alebrijes. And they all, everyone was just so warm and welcoming and happy to share their traditions, walk us to the town cemetery, show us their family grave sites. Just really, everyone was just so warm and we would just kind of quietly observe the family dynamics, and so much of that ended up being a part of the fabric of the film, of the story that we told. And sometimes little bits would come out of those family meetings that ended up in the film. Like, for instance, we were at somebody's house one day, and we were sitting in their friend's room, and just kind of visiting with them and their family friends who were coming by. And I noticed that the family dog, they had a basset hound, and he kept sneaking into the room, and he was trying to eat a muffin off the agenda. and the mother and the family would kind of, you know, try to sweep him out the door, and then the dog would turn around and creep back in and try to eat food off it again. And it struck me as being so funny, and I filed it away. And so now we have the moment in the movie where Dante jumps on your friend and feeds him away. So there are a million little things like that. And those, to me, like when I think back on the experience of researching, you know, the time we spent in Mexico, it's those times we spent with the family that are the most dear to me.
One more.
I'm going to go to the guy right here.
It's an interesting idea. I'd love to hear you guys talk about this, because for me personally, my family was always really supportive of what I wanted to do. I didn't have a family that tried to push me in a more practical direction, but I did work with a lot of people in the movie that had very different stories, who did have families that didn't approve of them going into making movies or animation and wanted them to be attorneys or doctors.
I mean, I had the same experience. My parents were very supportive. I grew up in New Jersey. They had, Italian Americans. They had no idea what it was to make a movie, but I knew that I knew I wanted to do that, to work in the movies. So they were just completely supportive of that throughout my entire, career growing up. Always, they were like, I don't know how to do this. I don't know how to help you do this, but we'll do what we can for you.
Yeah.
So the idea of family and the music was so important to me, just to have that feeling of family. My mom has an ofrenda room, and we're Italian. Every relative that was ever a Giacchino or a Fortunato is up on that wall. And when I saw this film for the first time, I was like, I have one of those. And I was like, except it never comes down; it's constantly up there. My parents were out at the scoring session, and they love it. But for me, the whole experience of family, not just within our own past, but even with just working together, at Pixar, there's incredible family there as well. So,
what about you, Danny?
Yeah, my parents were super supportive, but not for animation. go to school, go to college, get a great job. So I had a baby at a young age and got married instead, and decided I wanted to work in animation. It was like, you're like, great. How do you make that work? So that obviously it was very, that just didn't seem possible to them, because that just didn't exist. That for them to see me doing what I'm doing now, I mean, they're they always tell me now that they're how impressed they are, you know, and how supportive they are now. And but at, before it wasn't that. Like my dad gave me this like hour long talk once about how am I gonna, what am I gonna do now? And so I'm like, I'm gonna make it work.
You started on Monsters.
I started on Monsters Inc. Yeah, as a PA back in 2001.
But you know, I mean, like families, I feel like most of the time when they do that, it's out of a sense of protection.
Right.
Right. Just because they want the best for you, and they may not understand that avenue you're going for. But you know, so it's easier to say, well, don't do that. Do this. I know this works. I have no idea if this works.
Well, certainly, I mean, like for me, I think my family, I was an artist in the family, and they were generally supportive. But society doesn't. It didn't lend itself, like in my mind, art wasn't necessarily practical. So I tried to keep having backup plans. So I still, if this doesn't work out, I could still go and waitress.
I think this movie's going to work out. On behalf of Asifa, I want to, and the audience, I want to thank the crew here.